Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and if you're new here, my name is Esther Mofrey. So in today's video, I want to share with you, or I want to show you, how much you should start trading Forex. So this is the video that I was looking when I was starting Forex trading, and I thought that many people who did such videos, they didn't give me enough information that I wanted as a newbie, as a new beginner who didn't know even what is Forex and what I was getting myself into. So the information that was out there when I was looking such videos, I didn't feel like it was really open and like straightforward, and I'm here to give you a straightforward answer, because I don't need to go around the bush. It's better I just tell you what you really what is required. So in this video, I will show you, or I'll share with you how much is good for you to start like Forex trading. How much should you start Forex trading with? So if you're interested, continue watching, and don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. If you've not subscribed to my YouTube channel, kindly consider subscribing. So without wasting any time, let's get into the video. So how much do I need to start Forex trading? This is a question that I get a lot, and I also asked myself the same question when I was starting Forex, so I understand about this question, and it's very important, because this is where now you begin your journey of trading Forex. Is the first initial capital that you put, you deposit to start trading Forex. So I know it's a very important question. That's why I'm here to answer you, and I will give you my honest opinion or my honest advice. So I will give three accounts. I'll try to give you pros and cons on three accounts. That's how I can answer this question best, for you to be the judge. I cannot tell you you should start with $1,000, because I don't know if you don't have $1,000, and I cannot tell you to start with $10. Maybe even you have $10,000. So I don't want to limit anyone. I'll just give you pros and cons, because when someone is starting a Forex trading and wants to deposit the money, it's either you deposit $10, $100, or $1,000 according to your ability. So let's not even go to $5. Let's say $10. Let's say this person A with $10 account, person B with $1,000 account, and person C with $1,000 account. And what I can do on this video is to show you the pros and the cons of every person A to C, so that you be the judge. Because if someone told me this information, I could have judged better. But if I come here and I tell you the best money to start is $1,000, I'll be unfair to that person who has $100 and that person who would just have $10. So let's start. So I have said I'll give you the pros and the cons of $10, $100, and $1,000. So let's start with the pros. So, and then we go to the cons. The pros are the advantages. So before even you begin to ask yourself how much you want to start with, you really need to know which broker can give either the 10, the 100, and the 1,000. Most of the traders who want 100 and 1,000, they don't allow the $10. But if you get a $10 broker, they will allow any amount. So the first thing is to understand, if I'm on the $10 account, I really want to find a broker who will accept my $10 account. Now that one is done, you have the broker now. So the first thing to ask yourself is, what are my goals? Am I the person who wants to come and take Forex as am I here to stay, or am I just doing to try? If you're doing just to try, I would say go with the $10 account, because this, some people join Forex trading because of either influence, they have seen people doing trading, there's a video I said, know your why. They don't have a valid why they even want to do Forex. So if you're such a person, you don't have any attachment, you just feel like, ah, this Forex, I just hear about it, you can start with $10. There's nothing to lose there. But if you're that person who has been feeling that you really want to do Forex, start with $100 or $1,000. Now let me give you an advantage. The $10 is available. If you lose $10, You're not feel inch. So for the for that person A, the first advantage, if you lose your money, you're just losing $10. That's the first advantage. And then the second advantage is easily, maybe even you have $10 spared somewhere, you not need to look for that money. And yeah, that's the advantage of the $10, I guess. It is either it's readily available. If you lose the $10, it's gone and you forget. It's like going to like taking a lunch and forget. That's the advantage of $10. The advantage of $100 is that if you start with $100, you become more serious. Not like the $10 is not serious, but you are more attached. Remember, you're giving your $100 to try Forex, so you'll be more attached. If it's learning required, you will learn more. If it is to analyze market more, because remember, your account is big. So you will learn, you are more attached. And if you go to $1,000, there's more even attachment. And if you start trading, you will get good returns because of the profits. Now let's go to the cons of those three accounts. The cons that I have seen, and this is something that I didn't know, now I'm telling you to understand, it's about lot size and risk management. On the video that I will just put it here, things that I didn't know when I started Forex trading is the importance of lot size. And many people go wrong because of not paying more attention on the importance of lot size. So the $10 account, the $100 account, and the $1,000 account, if all of them use the same the same lot size, who is likely to benefit? Of course, the one with the higher amount in his account. So when it comes to the lot size, the $10 account, you cannot do any lot size except from the micro, the smallest. You cannot even go to the mini, because the mini needs a lot of money, so it needs more like $100. So the $10 account, the first con, you are limited when it comes to placing trade. You can just be in that position of micro, of the 0.01. that's one of the disadvantage. And there is no breathable space of the lots, the stop loss. And let's say we are told to risk 2% of our initial amount. So 2% of $10, you can calculate, it's you're risking, as it is not breathable even to do trades. And that's why, if you're listening to this video, $10 account, if you really want to be serious in trading, it may not be favorable for you, because there's no breathing space. You cannot be able to put your stop loss, because it's like you'll be risking half of the account. If you calculate 2% of $10, it's very low. So how will you trade? There's no space of breathing when you are trading with $10 account. That's the first con. The trading, the lot size, it is not favorable. If you use even the micro, remember, it is the 2% of micro, you are risking $2 with the $10 account, and that's 20%, which is high, because you just need 5 trades to lose and you lose the whole $10. Okay, we go to the $100 account. At least with the $100 account, you can have the lot size, but you cannot have the lot size of 0.1, but you cannot enter many positions. That's the other con. But I think that con is not effective, because when you're beginning, you don't need to open many positions. And there are 1,000, there is no con. The only con with the 1,000 is that when you think you have so much money, you start opening positions and becoming greedy. So I think what I can say in general, because I don't want this video to be big, when it comes to know how much you want to start trading, ask yourself two questions. Am I investing my time in this trading? Is this really what I want? If this is something that you want to give a try and you are so in it, go for $100 account or $1,000 account. If it's something that you just want to see, or let me just try and maybe I can change my mind. If you try with a $10 account, remember to always deposit, like you are funding more money in your account. Don't remain on the $10, because the chances of blowing a $10 account are very high. very high, because you, even if you risk $1, that you're risking 10% of your account, and it's supposed to be, you are supposed to risk 2%. So I hope you have understood about how I have done the three accounts. If you have the $1,000 and you're a beginner, you may be tempted even to put as a lot size of one, which is very dangerous with a standard lot, with a $1,000 account, because you'll be risking 20%. You should use a micro, you should use the mini lot size, because you'll be risking 2%. So between the three accounts, because it's either you put $10, $100, and $1,000, I would really highly suggest $100. And $100 is what I started with, and from there, the only mistake I did when I started trading, I didn't know the importance of the lot size. So even if I started the $100, I went straight away to a mini lot size. So I was risking 20% of my account. I was supposed to risk 2%. So I was supposed to trade with the micro, with the micro lot size. I was supposed to use 0.01. So you understand? So it has those things. You need to put everything together. So when you start with a $100 account, you need to stick to micro lot size. Don't go to mini lot size, because mini lot size, you are risking 20% of your account. If you have money and you have taken this serious, you have studied and you want a $1,000 account, if you start with a $1,000 account, you can risk a mini lot size of 0.1. You'll be risking 2% of your account. If you have a $1,000 account, please avoid standard lot, one standard lot. Avoid it completely. If you have a $100 account, avoid one standard lot and mini standard lot. Work with micro standard lot. Okay guys, I hope you have understood. I hope for some who may not understand about micro, mini, and those, it may be a bit challenging to understand, but if you have understood, you can repeat this video. All I'm saying is about when you want to start, when you want to start trading, that amount, the initial amount you want to deposit, it will really affect the lot size you will put and the risk management. So if you are supposed to risk 2%, kindly stick to from $100, because the $10 account, you will not be able to even risk 2%, because it is very tiny. So from $100 you can start risking 2%. From $1,000 you can risk 2% per trade, and you can start seeing growth. So guys, that was it about how much do I need to start forex trading. If this video has helped you, give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to comment down below. Let me know, how much do you start forex trading, or how much is your account, how are your lot sizes, how is your risk management. Comment down below, I want to hear. Until next time, bye bye, love you.